हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मिसेस वासंती रेवतकर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी श्री ज्ञानेश महाविद्यालय नवरगाव. टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम ट्राइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फैमिली एस्क्लेपिडियेसी, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैमिली ऑफ डायकॉट. एंड दिस फैमिली इज ऑफ ग्रेट इकोनॉमिक वैल्यू ड्यू टू सम प्रेजेंस ऑफ सम जेनरा इन द फैमिली. The content of this topic is systematic position of family Asclepiidaceae, then diagnostic features of the plants present in this family, important genera which are included in this family Asclepiidaceae, then distribution of the genera, then habitat and habit, and vegetative characters, reproductive characters, and economic importance of the plants which are present in this family. After that, some plants which are of special importance, they are discussed here. Then systematic position, division, phanerogam, subdivision, angiospermie, class dicotyledon, subclass gametophyte, then series, bicarpality, order gentianalis, and the family Asclepiidaceae. This is about the systematic position of this family. Then distinguishing character. Plants are with milky latex, generally perennial erect herbs or lianas, shrubs, and rarely trees are found there. Sometimes cactus like trees and plants are found in this family, and most of the plants present in this family are xerophytic in nature. Then leaves are simple, opposite or whorled, and stipules minute. Then inflorescence is a cyme which may be dicaxial or monocaxial, or rarely raceme, and umbelliform type of inflorescence also can be seen in this family. Flowers usually bisexual, then regular, typically pentamerous with reduction in gynoecium. Corolla rotate with twisted or valvate estivation. Stamens 5, then filaments very short or none. Sometimes stamens are modified to translator, that we will see later on when we will discuss about the androecium, which joined with the gynoecium to form the gynostegium condition. Polar either in tetrad or glandular, or cohere to form the wax-like pollinia or the bag-like pollinia. The carpels two free, superior ovary with two free styles, but joined and spreading about to form the five-lobed stigmatic head. Ovules numerous, anatropous, attached on the ventral and parietal placentation. Then fruits are in a pair, or it is called as a pair of follicles, and seeds generally have tuft of hairs apically. Then distribution. The members of this family are distributed chiefly in the tropics. Very few species occur in cool temperate region. In our country, the family is represented by Asclepias, then Calatropis gigantea, Calatropis procera, then Cryptostegia glandiflora, then Oxystelma, and Pergularia demia. These are the some of the main important plants which can be seen in our country. Then habitat and habit. Most of the plants are shrubby climbers or lianas with milky latex or perennial herbs. Example, Oxystelma esculentum. Or small trees are also found, like Calatropis gigantea and Calatropis procera. Commonly we call these as ek or rui. Most of the flowers are used for the medicinal purposes. Then Hoya species is the succulent, and Stapelia is cactus-like xerophytes with reduced thorn or scaly leaves. Then Dystidia is a epiphytic plant which climbs by the adventitious root. Then vegetative characters of this family. It starts from the root, we know that the family belongs to dicot, naturally there will be the taproot system and they are branched. Then endotrophic mycorrhiza is also generally present in the succulent species. Then stem, it is generally twining or herbaceous or woody. The stapelia has fleshy stem and laticiferous vessels, and bicolateral vascular bundles are present in the stem. Then about the leaf, generally opposite and decussate leaves are present, sometimes whorl, rarely alternate, linear to orbicular or ovate in shape. They are entire, means margin is having entire margin, reticulate venation with strong cuticle with waxy coating, sometimes reduced to or modified to feature, like example Dystidia rafflesiana. Then reproductive character starts from the inflorescence, and here inflorescence is of two type. One is sometimes it is cymose or sometimes it is racemose. When cymose, it is dicasial cyme in which ultimate branches become monocasial, and when it is racemose type, it may be umbel. Then after inflorescence there is flower, because these flowers are arranged on the inflorescence. We can define the inflorescence, arrangement of flower on the floral axis is called as inflorescence. That's why the flowers, they are arranged in a on the axis, floral axis. Then flowers are small or large, typically pentamerous, hypogynous, means having superior ovary. Bract and bracteoles may be present here this is. Then corolla, flower is hermaphrodite, means bisexual, and it is complete because all the four whorls are present: calyx, corolla, androecia and gynoecium. So we can now we will study the calyx. Calyx is made up of five sepals. These sepals are free, are basically conate, deeply cleft and imbricate estivation or sepal posterior. Here the sepals are here. Then corolla, it is the characteristic feature of family Asclepiadaceae, because corolla there is petals are there, but apart from these petals there are coronary appendages can be seen. We will study later on. So petals 5 united at the base, these are at the base, they are fused and deeply divided, brightly colored, rotate or salver shaped, with deep tube. Then coronal appendages arise either from the corolla base or from the stamen. Here apart from these are the five petals, these are the petals, five petals are there, and which are made up of these are appendages. Apart from these five petals, there are some appendages here, pillar like appendages we can see, and they are giving support to the stigma. They are fixed to the stigma and they arise from the base of the petal, and that's why they are called as corolline corolla. It is also called as corolline corolla. Then androecium, here a special type of stamens are seen. Stamens, they are in the form of translator. So what is that? The stamens 5 in the form of translator, means these are two pollinia, and here is the a pair of corpusculum, a pair of arm, and from each arm there is formation of sac like structure which is called as the pollinium. There are two pollinium, so that we are calling it the pollinia, and combined structure, that is a pair of corpusculum, a pair of arm and two pollinia together, it is called as the translator. It is the modified version of stamen. Here translator, which are made up of a pair of corpusculum, a pair of arm and a pair of pollinia, generally adnate to the gynoecium, forming gynostegium. Here this translator, they are present at the, this is the gynoecium is made up of two ovary and then the style, and this is the stigma is pentangular, and it at each angle there is a there we found the androecium. Androecium is fixed in the corner of the gynoecium or stigma, so that's why it is called as the stage, it is called as the gynostegium condition. Anthers two-celled stamens may or may not have filament. If they are in a modified structure, translator here, so there is pollinia are there which contain pollen grains, but stamens they are, if sometimes it is present, but many a times it is modified into translator. Then gynoecium, it is bicarpillary syncarpus, ovary superior, ovules free, then ovaries, these ovaries are free, and both these carpels, they are united from the style, and stigma is here, combined stigma, which is pentangled. So style, two united either completely or base or only apically, and enlarged to form a stigmatic head. Then fruit is a pair of follicle here. There are two ovaries. After the maturation of this ovary, fruit is formed. That's why we can define the fruit as fruit is nothing but the ripened ovary. So here are two separate ovaries are there. That's why two separate fruits can be formed. These are called as the pair of follicle. Then this is the floral formula and floral diagram. These are calyx, five calyx, and then corolla. They are valvet, the imbricate type, and five stamens are there in the form of staminode, in the form of translator, and these are the translator. They are present at each one, at each corner. So five stigma is pentangled at each corner. There is a formation of this translator. That's why there are five translators, and at the center there is ovary. So floral formula, bract, bracteole, then actinomorphic, bisexual, calyx five, they are free. Then corolla, they are five, but gamopetalous condition, they are fused one. And androecium five, sometimes they are adnate to the corona, and sometimes it is mixed with the gynoecium. And gynoecium, bicarpillary, syncarpus, ovary superior. Then economic importance, this family is of great economic value because there are so many plants are present which are of some of them are medicinally important and some of them are ornamental, as they contain very beautifully colored flowers. Some first one is Asclepias, that is Kaktundi, it is a small herb or undershrub. Then Calatropis, there are two species of Calatropis, one is Calatropis gigantea and another one is the Calatropis procera. They are also the plants which can be used for stuffing the pillow. Then Cryptostegia grandiflora, this is also a rubber vine. Then Leptodenia reticulata, this is also the plant which is grown for its yellow, pale yellow flower. Then Pergularia dimia, it is the perennial climber, and it is found, it is wild plant most of the time. Then Sarcostelma stema acidum, this is also the plant which is present in this family. Then Stapelia species and Tylophora indica, there are more than 100 species of that, and we will see some important plants. The first one is Asclepias. As I told you earlier, Asclepias curassavica, it is the Kakatundi. Kakatundi means like a mouth of crow. It can be seen somewhat like that one, so that's why the name has been given. It is small herb or undershrub cultivated as an ornamental plant because of its beautifully colored flowers, very beautiful flower. Then Asclepias incarnata, this is the flowers which are of purple color and the stigma heads are white. So beautifully colored flowers are there, and this plant can be grown in the garden for its beautiful flowers. Then Baronella acuminata, This is the slender climbing shrub producing stem up to 6 meter long. The plant is harvested from the wild to local for its medicinal importance. It contains some medicinal property and that's why it is cultivated as a medicinal plant. Then Brachystelma barberi, it is a perennial herb or dwarf herb. One to few short annual stems are produced and disc-shaped underground rubber tree. Here, this is the underground rubber and it is underground tuber, and from this tuber there arises the plant. It is potato-like tuber is there. We can see easily. Here is the tuber, potato-like tuber is there. These are the roots, and from root the stem is arising, and these are nothing but the fruits of this plant. Then the tuber is depressed in the center and become irregular in shape with age. All above the ground part are covered with the coarse hair and produce a watery sap when damaged. Here watery sap we will get. This is also the fruit, is a follicle, fruits are there. This is the flower and this is the inflorescence and flower of this plant. Then Calotropis zigensia madar, in English it is called as madar or egg. It is a tall shrub or small tree with purple flower, seed fibers and floss used for stuffing the pillow. This is the purple color plant, the flowers are purple in color. And here at the it is gynostigium condition, and here stamens are reduced in the form of translator. Then another plant is Calotropis procera. This is also the Calotropis plant and but having the white flower, and it is also the shrub, and it is used medicinally because milky latex is present. When we break the leaf or any part of the plant, we will get the milky latex, and that milky latex is very important, that can be used in a medicine, and that's why this plant is cultivated as a medicinal plant. Then Caralluma hexagona, this is a plant. Hexagona means six like structure is there. It is upright and ascending, strongly branching succulent plant. It forms dense mat or clump of 20 cm tall with subterranean rubber or runner. Next is the Cincinnum lucer. It is an ornamental plant and found in the Europe. This is like a Calotropis zigensia and Calotropis procera. The flowers are very dark brown in color and very beautiful. That's why it can be used as a medicinal ornamental plant. Then next one is the Sinensium rosicum. This is also a continental plant, and it is specially made to make the prone or climbing into the contact of rare native plant, and this is also the wild plant found in the many region. Then this is the Seropegia species. There are 180 known species. 180 known species of Seropegia is found in different parts of our country and in the world also. So this is very large genus and having 180 species. All the species are having its own characteristic feature. Some are different in that inflorescence variations are found here with the color and all the ornamentation and large genus of this family. Then Hoya carnosa, this is a plant, it is a wax plant of the family, and when we break any part of this plant we will get wax like structure, very thick latex we will get, and it is called a wax plant. Then Hoya publicalis, that is jungle garden plant they are. And this is Leptodenia reticulata. this is very important, and we can use the we use this plant anatomy for anatomy. This is bicollateral vascular bundles are seen when we cut the stem, and it is very important, and very clearly it can be seen bicollateral vascular bundle in these plants, and that's why botanists they tremendously use this plant to get sections and all that things, or as a practical material, and that's why we should protect this plant. Then it is a Microloma calycinum, this is plant. Then Pergillaria demia, it is hedge plant, everywhere found. When monsoon season, there is the fruits are pair of follicle, then very very clearly seen, translators are seen, and this is the vine, and this plant has been used for traditionally to treat the number of alignments. Then this is Stathmostelum species. They are having different varieties or color on the basis of different colors of the flower. There are so many species of these plants are seen, and it is also the milky latex is present inside in all plant part. And this is about the Calotropis procera life cycle, showing LS of flower, then it is fruit, and this is a stigmatic disc, pollinia, and this is flowering twig, and this is seed having hairy pappus structure. Then for this I am very much thankful to you.